So we have currently three SMT lines. They're capable of basically 30,000 parts per hour. We have the capability to go down to 01 or 05 size components, which is a 10,000th of an inch by a 5,000th of an inch component. We do go down to 0201, which is 20,000ths by 10,000ths. We place quite a few of those components up to a larger component. So we have a large range of capability in our SMT lines. The newest line incorporates the universal pick and place machines. The newest line is a fusion machine that incorporates both an inline 7 gantry system and an AC30 gantry system. So the inline 7 is 7 nozzles that place larger components in a slower, more accurate mode. And the 30 head is a turret head system that is basically a chip shooter, so smaller components are placed at a very high speed. Since they're all universal equipment, we can transfer programs from line to line, so it really helps with capacity planning and throughput. So if we have a customer demand that upticks, we can switch it from its standard line over to another line and make the demands from a throughput standpoint. Since we have a small batch, large changeover, one of the biggest hurdles we have is changeover. So we try to get our changeover down to a 30-minute changeover time. And to do that, we have a system that we call a pit crew. So we'll call, just like in the racing industry, we want to change that over as quickly as possible. So that pit crew will be called and they'll come in and change everything over using a cart-based system so they can do bulk changeovers and change that over really quickly. There's things that have been implemented to enhance changeover, like a FIFO buffer after the screen printer, so that holds a X number of boards. It helps with the changeover because when that last board comes out of the printer, you have a number of boards left to go through the process. So the changeover, that printer can start right when that happens. By the time that last board leaves that buffer, the next board is coming down the line and it follows the line as they change over.
Our SMT capabilities here are pretty robust. I've heard from customers that they're some of the newest technology that they've seen. Through our Universal Fusion, to the Universal Advantis, to the 3D AOIs, to our TOFU system, which is touch-only failed units, it really streamlined our SMT process. So through our TOFU system, where we touch-only failed units, boards are automatically loaded into the screen printer, to the machines, through the oven, and through the 3D AOIs. The operator doesn't have to touch them except in certain circumstances where there may be hand-placed components, which is rare. Some of the other improvements we're looking at doing in SMT to just kind of continue this continuous improvement is integrating our X-ray counter with the smart shelving through to the universal machines. What we would be able to do is basically give the SMT operators a nearly empty alarm. So they'd be able to go and pull parts that they're going to be needed that are running low on the reels. Moving down the line to the 3D AOIs, this is probably where we get a lot of the compliments from customers. Previously, we had 2D AOIs, which would basically give you presence or existence of the components. It wasn't really great at showing if the component had enough solder or had the exact right height on the placement. The 3D AOIs allow you to view the components in 3D and view the PCBs in 3D. So you can see the solder strength. That's something that they can measure. You can get better quality through that machine and trust that machine because it's 3D capable.
We offer what we call sort of medium volume manufacturing. And so a customer who might not have super high volume, but needs a couple hundred units a month. That's one of the areas that we very effective in. And so we've got some tools behind us that help support that, including the smart racks here, the smart inventory system that we use for kit pull, which makes it efficient. The only way we can be effective in reducing those lot sizes to do it at the lowest possible cost. And so to do that, we have to be pretty efficient. And one of the areas that helps us with that is this material flow, the stock, the way that the inventory moves, the way that we're able to set it up ahead of a build in terms of like a kitting cart so we can make the changeover of the line very efficient. And so I think that's maybe how I would describe our SMT process being effective for us, I guess. Well, we chose to invest for a couple of reasons in the SMT machine in particular. Again, we have multiple segments of our business that serve different customer sets in very low volume versus medium volume. And this new machine really gave us a platform that was suitable to produce those products on a single machine. So it has a dual beam in it, one with a high precision placement nozzle in conjunction with the high speed revolver nozzle. And so we could potentially then, and effectively did, retire some of our older SMT gear, because this equipment is suitable to sort of merge both that medium volume, that low volume onto one platform. So it's very flexible, can go both ways. In terms of the investment in the X-ray counter, again, it's an operational risk, I think, as we look at the accuracy of our inventory. If it's inaccurate and we're trying to run a job, we create all kinds of inefficiencies. If we go to set that job up and find out the parts aren't really here, it creates downtime on the machine. It causes us to have to disrupt our suppliers and try to get material in quicker, costs us more money typically to do that. And so the efficiency of the machine to be able to do really rapid counting and accurate counting has been a huge benefit. And then if you put that in conjunction with our smart feeder system, manages our first in, first out system very well, makes sure that operators are picking the right part. It obviously creates some intelligence that picking from a standard rack might not produce, so it reduces the risk of creating a defect when we do the assembly.
We use a smart shelving system. It's a Clouseau is a manufacturer. And what we look at there is the take and place times for a component, right? So in the previous system, there were racks and they were numbered. And an employee would go get a reel and they'd look at that rack, and it would take them about a minute average to search and find that part and get it ready to go. The smart shelving system, it's all a handheld system and it's all digital, right? So you scan what you need and it lights up and you go right to it, and it's about a 10 second put in place or put take in place time. We've shortened that time dramatically, and actually the payback on that system was about 6 months. There's other things that we've done to optimize our efficiency, like the conveyor before the oven. We've programmed it so it automatically feeds the board into the oven. We're not having an operator put the boards in the oven. It automatically adjusts to the conveyor speed of the oven and puts the boards in the oven, which again means that we don't need an operator standing there. So our whole goal is to make things more efficient and less interaction with an operator.
Our machine lines have been really enhanced over the last couple of years, and very much hands-off for an operator from the time the board is put in the front of the machine till the time the board comes out the back of the machine. It's essentially all machine handled and managed. And again, that creates a higher quality product, creates a reliable throughput and efficiency. And I think those, including the automated optical inspection at the end of the line, that has yielded our ability to just sort product for defects very quickly when they do occur, and really simplify our whole processing of printed circuit board assemblies, is a big win for us in the last couple of years.